Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable. ICICI Prudential Life Insurance and CNBC TV 18 present Mission Insure India. Life insurance for all.
Hello and welcome to Mission Insure India. This series is a joint initiative between CNBC TV 18 and ICICI Prudential Life Insurance to create awareness and disseminate knowledge about insurance and the need to protect one's family. Today, our focus is on the role of distribution. Before we get into discussion mode, here is an interesting observation made by Peter Thiel, co-founder of PayPal and author of Zero to One. In his book, he says, you can't win without distribution. It is one thing that every company must have in order to be successful. Businesses may have competitive advantages and brand messages, but without a winning distribution strategy, there is no business. Does the same hold for the insurance product? Let me ask the experts here. Mr. Neeraj Chokshi, co-founder, NJ India Invest. Mr. Pranav Mishra, Senior General Manager, Retail Liabilities Group, ICICI Bank. Mr. Rahul Parekh, CEO of Bajaj Capital. And finally, Mr. Amit Palta, Chief Distribution Officer, ICICI Prudential Life Insurance. Gentlemen, welcome to the show. I want to start with the obvious. The insurance penetration in the country is very low. It is as low as 2.72% compared to the global average of 3.47%. And the same holds true for the density. It is about $46.5, versus the global average of $353. So my question is, what are the prime reason for this poor penetration? It is lack of awareness. Is it mindset? It is lack of distribution. What could be the reason? So starting with you, Amit.
Actually, I would like to see it as an opportunity. And there is a context. The context goes back into a decade prior to 2000, when insurance was mostly positioned on the savings platform with bit of protection and tax solutions to our customers. And while savings, protection and tax savings was one category that existed within insurance, how it evolved after 2000 was about extending it to involve investments on a unit link platform and subsequently even getting standalone protection as a category.
Let me get Rahul in. Rahul, he said it has evolved. But yet when you look at countries like Malaysia, Singapore or China, we're still far behind. But he's saying it is optimistic. There's a big growth in front of us. Your own take.
So my take on this is that while I agree with him that there is a huge opportunity, I think the reason why the penetration levels are so low in a country as vast and as expansive as India is primarily because, one, I think from a financial literacy point of view, there is a huge gap and people have misunderstood the product. Number two is that I think insurers have insured complexity of the product. And the lack of simplification means that many customers don't even understand what policies they are buying, and often not, they end up kind of misunderstanding what they are getting into it for. And last but not the least, I believe that I think the operational hassles are far too many for a human being to kind of be so persistent to go through the entire process and get themselves insured.
Very well put. He says there are various issues, but the things are looking better going forward. Your own take.
So my take is basically, if you look at, it has to do with the socio-economic pattern of the society. So when I talk about socio-economic pattern, India has been a typical savings economy. So when it comes to cover or protection, where insurance penetration is 2.72%, it is to deal with that 33% of India's population has an average income of less than 1.5 lakh. 45%, the next, which are the next billion, which is around what you called as 1.5 lakh to 5 lakh. So you are left with a 28% of population, which is with surplus, which is where he starts looking towards beyond his household need to go in for. So when we compare it to the world, which is at 3.5%, 2.72% looks to be small. And simultaneously, as far as insurance as a product line is concerned, yes, it has been advocated as a tax saving product, is the second biggest reason for the penetration being low. But the good news is that in last 5 years, with things like PMJJBY, PMJJSY, insurance is catching at a very, very fast pace.
Do you also think it was largely dominated by public sector company? This is why the entry of private sector made a big difference to the sector?
Obviously, I think as and when there is competition, you will see simplification of products, you will see cost efficiencies, you will see various modes of distribution evolving out. So competition is always welcome. And with private sector and a lot of international players coming in, they've brought the best practices which they have experienced worldwide, where the penetration of insurance is far more than what we have seen in India. So I agree, but I think insurance and things like that are a one-on-one kind of a counseling which needs to take place effectively, because it's a very, very simple need. But one has to, and as human beings, we have a nature of procrastinating things. I may know that it's an important need for me, but I need someone to talk about that and make it happen.
Amit, people buy smartphones, buy cars, plan for holidays. But when it comes to buying insurance as a product, there's some kind of a mindset. What are the reason for this, and how do you change this mindset?
Okay, I'll pick up from what Pranav spoke about socioeconomic factors. You know, almost half the population who's insurable actually happens to be the young demographic, what we call it as demographic dividend for India. Yeah. Incidentally, this is the life stage when actually customer is into consuming stage, where the reserves built up actually is lesser. And if you ask me in terms of priority, he actually look at consuming more. But at the same time, the good part again, like I'll stay optimistic here, because the recent uptake that we have seen on the credit life kind of products, where people have started covering their consuming patterns, like every personal loan, people are covering it with something so that there is no liability left for the family, is one very positive trend that has been witnessed in last couple of years.
Would you say that the millennials are, as there's a sense of cockiness, nothing will happen, so I don't want to go for the cover? And people are above 50 want to go for a cover. It's a quite a catch 22 situation.
No, that's a very interesting one. While it is being perceived that they don't care about something like this, but if you ask me, he's very confident about his future, his ability to earn, his ability to increase his income over a period of time. So he's very confident about meeting his liabilities. But the only thing which he's not being able to meet is something which is as unfortunate an incident like death. Right. So to that extent, that awareness which has been seen very positively over the last couple of years.
Vinay, you want to add to that?
Yeah, I think while I would repeat again that it is basically the conversation between the IFA, the distributor and the customer, that is the most critical thing, because one will have to assure that this is a very important need and one should save first before making the consumption. So I think it's and now the term plans are so cheap, so one can cover adequately and the protection is there for the family.
The question I want to ask you is, there are more than 700 life insurance products available in the market that can cater to consumer at every price point. Do you think that the too many insurance product is confusing the people and they don't know what to do and how to go about the whole thing?
Yes, I believe that there is a proliferation of products. There is too much available with minor tinkerings left best to a expert to kind of understand and decipher. And I agree with Neeraj Bhai when he says that, you know, there is a need for you to have somebody who's sitting down with you and making you disciplined enough to get the right product for you.
So you need the right advisor, you're saying. Pranav, you want to add to that?
If you look at a consuming economy or a savings economy, you will have variety. And are these 700 life insurance product really unique or relevant for a particular strata of income? And if it gets categorized into different income level, say 10 product each, or for family members another, and it ends up into 700 600, I think that's perfectly fine.
So what do you think is the role of the aggregator like Policy Bazaar, CoverFox? Have they come and deepened the market? Have they really helped? And what happened to the existing line of business?
So let me first comment on the fact that you know, what is the role of a technology and what is the role of human being? I think technology is best at managing efficiency, and human beings are best at managing emotions, right? And I don't think we should try to interplay the roles. To our mind, I think it's a combination of both. So we believe tech plus touch is much more effective than either tech or either touch. A lot of aggregator models that we are talking about, I think to that extent, it is actually good, because what they're doing is that there are more number of people speaking about insurance to various different customers. Yeah. And the need of the insurance is getting more and more prevalent in the market. So to that extent, it's good for all of us. But having said that, I believe that, you know, at the end of the day, the role of an advisor is to know his client and then effectively choose the right product on behalf of the client, and not the other way around, that you know you have a product and everybody's carpet bombing. So to that extent, that one-to-one personal counseling and understanding your client to select the right thing for the customer, understanding his family, understanding his life state, understanding his emotional needs are extremely important part of making a decision of right product for him.
I want to get Pranav in actually. Now I understand Amazon, Flipkart and Paytm are looking at entering this space. Do you think this platform can be used to educate people? And will they also help widen and make create more awareness in the marketplace?
So any kind of a commercial activity, so whether it is an e-commerce or an activity which is happening in any of the setups which are in physical brick and mortar model, I think it's always good for any industry. And as far as usage of those set of platform in terms of popularizing is best, because that's where you will get the consumption pattern of an individual, and through consumption you can easily assess what exactly can be extrapolation towards his income, and income can give a very clear cut direction that what kind of cover you can do.
How do the private distributor like NJ and Rahul look at this whole distribution challenge? Yeah,
so I would say that I'm actually happy to let them come in the industry, and I would say bring them on, because any entity which has a reach, right, will only increase the awareness. Having said that, I agree with what Pranav was talking about, that I think in digital, it's important to use the data the right way to create the product in tune with what the customer needs is. And to that extent, I think there is an advantage of having a technology-led, data-led platform. But having said that, the interesting part, or at least why I am happy as a traditional distributor who's on a tech plus touch path, is primarily because they are actually burning investors' money to create the awareness, and the entire industry is benefiting. So I would say bring them on.
Well, on that note, we need to take a short commercial break. We'll be right back.
ICICI Prudential Life Insurance and CNBC TV18 present Mission Insure India. Life insurance for all. ICICI Prudential Life Insurance and CNBC TV18 present Mission Insure India. Life insurance for all.
Welcome back. We are talking about role of distribution in insurance products. Okay, let me get Amit in. Amit, we are talking about distribution, we are talking about personal touch. But the bulk of the complaint the ombudsman received is on mis-selling. And I think that could go against the industry. So how do you stop this menace of mis-selling?
What needs to be done, of course, as a step one is know your customer. Yeah. I think knowing your customer is most critical in this entire process, which is about knowing what life stage he is in, what is the financial appetite he has, what is the risk that he has, his ability to take risk in terms of savings or an investment or a marketly kind of a product, and his understanding of where the protection kicks in. I think that is something which is which needs to form a precedence in terms of the entire sales process. So I think the clarity, transparency and communication, I think that becomes most important in this entire sales process, the way product is offered to the customers. So I think that is one thing which I would like to say. Second is education, knowing about having understood the customer, what is the most appropriate product from the basket of savings, investments and protection, which takes care of the life stage need of that customer, and see and follow up with that life stage and see at what age band is the requirement changing. That's something that one needs to be very cognizant of and follow it up very closely. And be, of course, transparent and disciplined. Transparent in terms of what it means as a cost to the customer.
Anil, you want to add to that? Yeah,
I think evolution of regulations is very critical to ensure that the correct sales process takes place. And when we are talking about these tech-based platforms where there is no touch into it, I think there is important that misbuying doesn't take place. So there also the regulator has to be very, very cautious, because once the experience of a customer is bad, you are losing that customer for all time. Yeah. So I think, and that kind of experience is very, very critical. And I think while the principle of insurance is caveat emptor, that is buyer be aware, yeah, but unfortunately that's not the case. So I think at some point of time, regulations will have to evolve in such a way that there is no iota of any mis-selling which takes place. And those who are doing it fraudulently or with a malafide intentions, they have to be taken seriously.
Okay, let me mention Rahul, we talk about mis-selling. But how often you think the insurer or you should sit with your client and assess his portfolio, what kind of cover look at various milestones like marriage or education, all those things.
So we believe that in a holistic approach, holistic financial planning approach, when it comes to client, and insurance is just one part of that financial planning. So that process should be done at least every 6 months with the client. Every 6 months, at least it should be done. If it requires to be more frequent, it can be, but at least every 6 months you should do that. Primarily because 6 months is good enough a time to review whatever products you have given in the client's portfolio and whether it is still in tune with what the client's requirement as well as the current life stage is. I think it's important to do this process every 6 months.
Amit, how should an insurance advisor go about targeting the clients? We talk about mis-selling, we talk about...
See, targeting actually is followed very differently by various distribution channels, and specifically if I were to look at, say, a bank. A bank has a natural advantage of customers who are most frequent in transactions, and they are rich with data and have the ability to segment customers on life stage, on income, on geography, on so many ways. In the way a customer is transacting will actually give you a lot of information. So while banks have a natural advantage of that segmentation, when it comes to insurance advisor, he is typically representing an ecosystem where he himself comes from. And reach out to start with his own ecosystem to start influencing an insurance process with the customers in his ecosystem who he can go back and influence. That is what builds confidence, and that's where the network effect starts coming in. And what I mean by network effect is, like, once you start from your own ecosystem, then they get into their individual ecosystems, and slowly from your own ecosystem you start getting into your customer's ecosystem and start extending sales. So that is how typically it happens in insurance advisors.
It's a community approach.
So it's an entire community approach that starts start coming into play.
When it comes to advising the your client about renewing the policy, how often that should be done? And how often is it done actually?
Feel that there is a dual responsibility. There is a responsibility of an insurer to keep customer informed about his contract. And also there is a responsibility of an advisor to take his relationship to next level. And like what Rahul mentioned, that, you know, if you are taking and doing an assessment of a customer's changing life stage regularly, then you keep him informed not just about the features and the additional requirements, but also you keep reminding him about the key features of the product and also about his promise to pay right through the payment term of the insurance.
So, you know, interestingly, I just want to add to this that in Japan, the insurers have this concept called Zotomoto, which basically means that you have to meet the customer once every year to explain the policy benefit, irrespective of the need for selling or not. And what their experience has been that, you know, advisors which do Zotomoto regularly, which means every year they go and talk to the customer about the same policy and the benefits, they have better persistency, they have better cross-sell, because every time that you meet the client and remind the client about the policy and the reason why he bought it, it makes it that much more stronger for the guy to continue.
Okay, we're coming to the final question, Pranav. Finally, what are the right selling practices that every insurance distributor, intermediary, and advisory should follow to create a win-win situation for everyone in the ecosystem?
So I think one of the biggest thing is, while I say there are three stages of right selling. One is onboarding the customer. So promise what you can deliver. And during the life cycle, while he is there, regular communication, engagement with the customer, and then as far as exit is concerned, give him lot amount of comfort about the fact that in case of maturity or claim, I'll be there standing by you. So whether it is the touch model or even by phone, leave all possible details, because when the moment of truth is there for this particular product, the guy who has bought the product is not there. And that's where one of the most important thing in terms of right selling is, when you're doing a selling of life insurance policy, engage the family than the individual.
Neeraj, 30 seconds.
Yeah, I think need-based selling is the most critical thing. The first part is the understanding between the client and the advisor relationship. That's the most critical thing. And then every customer is different. So once you understand the needs, and on the basis of the need, you give them a proper portfolio, an insurance plan, a term plan, and it has to be reviewed on a regular basis. And persistency is the most important thing, that while you are buying a term plan, and if persistency is not there, if you don't pay your premium, then there is no point of buying that term plan. So the review mechanism has to be, there has to be a comprehensive sales process. and that has to be monitored and ensured that the purpose for which the customer is buying a product that is getting satisfied.
Okay, Rahul.
We believe in 3D process, where we say that, you know, how do we help customers simplify discovery stage. So a lot of us spoke about need, but many times customers themselves are not aware about their needs and why something has to be done at a point of time. So how do you, coexist with the customer and, you know, make him or her realize that there is a need to do something. That entire discovery process is something that we need to kind of simplify. Once you do the discovery well and, you know, give the options and select the right product for the customer, the other part is about design. So how do you design all the journeys of the customer, whether in online or offline space, in a manner that it's very easy and positive for the customer to go through the entire journey? And finally, it's about delivery, which is that, you know, how do you ensure that every moment of truth, whether it's at the time of buying product, it's at time of onboarding, and it's time of claim settlement, and like a lot of panelists said about continuous engagement, how do you deliver each of this moment of truth in the right experience? Once you do that, I think that entire cycle works beautifully well, both for the customer and for the organization.
Amit, final word, you've heard all the three people giving you a lot of inputs. So your final take.
Yeah, like I mentioned earlier as well, I think staying within the worldview of the customer, I think is one thing that I'll speak about. Second is equipping yourself with the knowledge about what you are proposing to the customer. Third is communication, overemphasis on communication so that there is a transparency. And last is the discipline. Discipline of ensuring that the contract that you are making with the customer is for life.
I think a lot of key takeaways coming from the experts here. But one word that comes to me and strikes me is you need to build a trust.
Yes.
I think that is very important. Gentlemen, thanks a lot for being on the show. It was a pleasure talking to all of you all here. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
ICICI Prudential Life Insurance and CNBC TV18 present Mission Insure India. Life insurance for all. Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.